If we ignore the campaign for its shit storytelling, and you want to focus around the PvP and the PvE,
yay!
I think it's where the most focused people will enjoy the most.
Hello, monkeys!
Because what more can you ask for?
Yeah, I don't even know. Like, I can't even tell you.
You're a dude in power armor and go hack and slash with friends and randoms alike.
I am now the alpha.
Then again, that's like pretty much what a brain rotters are like.
Me, Big Marine, for the Emperor. And by main Marine can take the whole planet by single Marine solo.
Plus, the missions in PvE are quite simple. Go do these objectives, and then get it done. They're going through the cutscenes with poor dialogue. The PvE and the PvP both have customizations, and you can unlock them by using the in-game credits.
Yay!
The problem I have with the customization is you have everything in the Primaris from color, armor, weapons, and symbols, but none in the Chaos Marines, and the only thing you have for that is color change. Also, no Emperor's Children and no Thousand Sons either in PvP customization. Then again, I know they will bring more updates to the game with their season pass, but it's really not worth it. It's because all you are paying for is extra colors and symbols.
Oh, brother, this guy stinks!
And it's not unique compared to the original game with its own DLC skins.
Yes! No! No! No!
At least they had their flavor. You had the Salamander, the Iron Hands, the Legions of the Dan, the Blood Angels, Blood Ravens, which was locked for like 10 years for some reason.
Release me!
Black Templars and Space Wolves.
Who's a good boy?
Oh, wait! Let's not forget about the Chaos Boys. We had the Alpha Legion, the Iron Warriors, Emperor's Children, and the Death God.
The loathsome Dung Eater.
Which makes it more reasonable to get those skins than having a recolored skin and just have a sticky symbol on it.
This is brilliant, but I like this.
Fuck it, you might as well go play Dawn of War 1, where its customization is all there and you can do it for free, with or without mods. There's a reason why they are still popular to this day compared to the other current games.
Finally. Some good fucking food.
What is also weird is that the Chaos Marines are the same height as the Primaris Marines.
What the fuck is this piece of shit?
Which feels off and might take your immersion away. They should be at least a tad shorter. I thought I was going crazy when I went in photo mode and checked the height in between Titus and then the Thousand Sons, and there aren't too different at all in between them.
Hey yo, what the fuck?
It's quite a nitpick, because the way the PvP is designed is like, alright, we have Primaris, and we have Chaos Marines that are a copy of the Primaris Marines, but different.
Cringe!
They move and have the same abilities, which sometimes it does feel odd for a corn berserker to grapple someone and start swinging with a knife.
Why are you gay?
When they should have, you know, running at max speed and have their chain axes ready to go, and start slashing those bitches. So what I'm saying is, there are things that don't make sense if you're trying to immerse yourself into the game.
What the fuck is that?
Then again, I think Lewitton is right on this one, boys. And then if the authors are correct, there is no such thing as canon.
There is no Easter Bunny, there is no Tooth Fairy, and there is no Queen of England.
Even though Lewitton was trying to justify its official GW lore until it isn't, but that's canon until it's retconned just with extra words.
I like your funny words, Magic Man.
Regardless, my point is, as official boys, we have Primaris Chaos Space Marines. Woo! And as official from GW, get ready for the models to come out and replace those little baby Space Marines.
But I like my Chaos Space Marines.
That's too damn bad!
They've been replacing those Space Marines and anyone else since fucking 8th edition. So say goodbye to those, and you will never see them again, and they will not be missed, my guy, because no one cares other than whatever is new and it's popular. In PvE, the missions are decent enough for you to play in. But in the PvP, the modes are quite limited. I know in my previous video I mentioned there should be a quick match button, but to have these modes be reduced this much, I think that's a bit of limiting the replayability and the options you're allowed to play in the game.
Spare change, ma'am.
Sure, you can enjoy it, but how long is that gonna last once you completed all the weapon upgrades and everything you've unlocked for armor and all that? 3 months tops?
Yes.
After that, it's nothing more than just a mediocre game.
50,000 people used to live here. Now it's a ghost town.
I've already mentioned gameplay in the last video, but I'll mention it here. Overall, it's an improvement from the original Space Marine game. It's pretty good. It's more fluid and smooth, despite its minor quirks like bolts of fire and stomping of a marine like it's on fucking Crocs. Regardless, shit story though. To note as well, you cannot make private matches, so all games are public only.
Impossible.
Which it is another downgrade from the previous original Space Marine game.
And stop staring at me with them big old eyes.
I know they will bring a private PVE game on the next patch, but that should have been in the game from the start, not after.
That was today!
The level up systems are different between the two modes, where in PvP, you're unlocking weapons based on your level of your class. Meanwhile in PvE, you have the weapons but you are unlocking their abilities. Same goes with the perk tree system. The more victories you have, either in PvP or PvE, you level up and unlock the armor. For now, you're just unlocking Primaris Marine armor. As an extra note, as I played a couple more games, I found out and realized that the hull system itself is very different from PvE in campaign, and that is, it regenerates.
What?
I'm sorry, I thought this whole time I was playing this whole game and thinking I would never get healed since there's no medic pack, so I'll just keep fighting and just regenerate shield. Nah, actually, surprisingly, they just have regeneration. Why couldn't this be in, like, universally from PvE and campaign?
Love of God!
Oh wait, it will make medic packs fucking useless. Alright, how about you remove that fucking useless trait and just have regeneration? I think that makes more sense. And also, if you noticed, Space Marines do heal themselves with their anatomy. If it can be done in Space Marine, if it can be done in Halo, if it can be done in any other game that has regeneration and if done well, why not any other fucking modes in Space Marine 2? Like, the more you look into it, the more you find it's just silly. As I stated before, with easy anti-cheat, the game will most likely won't handle long after a couple of months. Because easy anti-cheat was never quite good blocking against hackers and cheaters, from experience at least. The voice acting in PvP is very flat. There's no emotion added to it.
Gods are watching. An enemy closes in on Vic. This is Imperial territory. Imperial Metro's assault our territory! Our warband holds the advantage! Traitors attack our terrain!
And no, not that World War II written from high school drama shit where two super elite soldiers are just talking and gossiping with each other instead when they should be like Doom Guy and start smashing heads and say nothing. Plus, they all talk like they are normal dudes in power armor, even though they wear a helmet.
Inserting munitions!
All specs ready to scan.
Frag grenade deployed!
Vision reveals the blind faith.
Activating all specs advanced.
One of ours goes to rot!
Battle, brother!
Iron endures all!
Like, where's my crack warp marine who's into fucked up shit? And he speaks really weirdly and different that is like almost human that is not.
Feel our wrath, die scum! Skulls for the skull throne! The power of chaos gives us strength!
Where's my marine who's stoic and proud for his chapter? But instead, we have McDonald's employees that just got voice acted.
For the Emperor!
Marine squad deployed. Fear denies faith. For the glory of the Imperium.
The class systems when playing PvP or PvE are limited either to play one or two classes each. You can't really do much more than for what the game is offering you. The fuck is this, Overwatch 222 fucking system? Oh! And because you don't have a private game, you can't really customize what your game's gonna be or how fun you wanna make it.
What?
No, since everything is online as I'm recording this video, you are limited to what the developers have assigned it for you. Tough luck. I like when you press tab and you instant move to one location to another. Then again, you are only moving to two places. So the feature doesn't mean much really.
This is worthless.
If you are curious how your class works, you can do the trials and have some additional rewards, but it's optional. It's something you don't really need to do, but it's there regardless if you want to give it a shot.
I mean, it's alright, like...
Because what the game has to offer is the extensions of the campaign, which is the PvP and the PvE. The campaign? Well, I've already said what I said. Shit story, shit dialogue, good gameplay and lots of fucking retcons of how Space Marines and Tyranids are meant to work. They just threw that in the fucking bin. And yeah, overall the game is meh.
I mean, it's alright, like, overrated as fuck.
But as a 40k game, you know how the drill goes.
That I love, I absolutely love.
I love this game, I love Primaris, they're so good. GW has the top tier models even though I don't buy them or play them on tabletop. What? You love Warhammer 40,000 as well? Well, let me tell you about Rylanor, the best fucking dreadnought ever to beat a fucking Primarch, even though it's a Chaos Demon. Oh, you know, Redcons, they do it all the time, and they're gonna do it again. I don't care. You wanna know about Titus, the greatest Space Marine of them all, who is an Ultramarine and has plot armor, and
too much soy in my body.
Overall, that is for it for this video. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you on the next video. Goodbye, my brothers, and take care.